victory. I always win. 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Check, 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 check. 1, 2. What's up, y'all? It's a Friday. My day. Your day. Because it's a Friday. What's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? Can you tell I'm happy it's Friday? I'm very happy. I've had such a week. But what's new? What's new with me? But what is new with me? I went to the grocery store today. Spent a lot of money on stuff. Did a little work, per usual. I watched some TV, but not a lot. And yeah, that was really it. Just trying to make it through this week, man. Hyping myself up every day. I hope y'all doing the same. Because that's all we can do in this crazy world we live in. I did not see the news today. I don't know what I was doing. I'm kind of waiting on the bridge for this song so I can turn it up. I wonder if Pandora's ever done the fast forward yet. I got a thing. I always win. 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 Come on. Hey, y'all better tell that devil y'all gonna always win. Okay, I was really, that's why I was distracted because I was waiting on a bridge for that song. Don't follow me. Don't follow me. Don't follow me. All right, let's get into this news. Let's see what happened while we slept or while we, whatever we did today. Let's see what's cracking. Maybe my phone don't want me to read any news because the show ain't trying to bring it up. All right. Let's see what this crap's saying. All right. Hunter Biden faces new indictment charges. He got like 9 tax charges. Is he gonna go to jail? I don't know. Does he care if he goes to jail? I don't think so. I feel like he'll be in there with his buddies. He seemed like the kind of guy to just want to hang out with criminals. I don't know. Hunter Biden just looks shit. He's like the shifty Joe Biden. You know? Senator Kevin Cramer's son is charged in a car chase that killed a sheriff's deputy. Mm-hmm. The University of Las Vegas gunman who shot 4 faculty members, killing 3, had a target list. Some news anchor gave the finger to an audience in a viral video. I don't know what her beef is, but she's from Britain, of course. She's giving the finger live on air, seemingly unaware that she was being filmed. I don't know why she gave the finger, but there she goes. Woman jokingly takes a picture of a van in front of her and wakes up in jail the next day. Ugh. Another creepy teacher or substitute teacher arrested for allegedly pulling down his pants and exposing himself to the class. A woman knocks a Kroger clerk unconscious as her 1-year-old was in a shopping cart. A 1-year-old child sat in a shopping cart as her mother knocked a Kroger worker unconscious, according to Michigan police. The 20-year-old was in the self-checkout aisle with her daughter and her child on December 4th. It's an image, so it's super, I don't know, it's funny. I don't know, y'all know I laugh at crazy stuff. But anyway, she began screaming at the clerk at the store, and she asked the worker for help removing the items from the tab, but the employee walked away. The surveillance footage obtained shows the mother leave her cart and walk over to the worker, hitting her in the face and knock her on the ground. The victim did lose consciousness for a bit and was transported to the hospital for treatment. The worker suffered a black eye and other head injuries, but is expected to be okay. Police charged a mother with an aggravated assault, and she is due in court in January. But listen, hear me out. That lady was sick of y'all. Do you understand? Self-checkout. It's already stressful. Y'all already watching everything people do. And all you supposed to do on self-checkout is be able to check your groceries out and leave. But no, when it's an error, we can't do nothing. We gotta wait on you. And then you have the nerve to turn around and walk away? I mean, I do not condone violence, but I'm just saying, some people be ready to snap. Y'all are the workers. Y'all there for 8 hours. We just trying to be in the store under 20 minutes. We ain't trying to be there all day with you too. Sick of y'all. But, you know, I pray that the mom gets probation. Liz Cheney is likely won't run in 2024. She don't want to run for president. She wouldn't win anyway. Same as Chris Christie. I don't know why he's playing around. Mom finds 6-year-old cheerleader dead in a Texas apartment. Police say she was murdered. Rest in peace to that girl. We already know the Hamas war is still going on. Dozens of Texans confronted a school board over a trans teen's removal from school play. Now he's back in the lead role. IKEA customer horrified after discovering her sofa has doubled in price since 2019. Horrified? That's kind of how inflation works, but okay. Let's see what else we got here, y'all. Melania Trump allegedly wants her husband to have Tucker Carlson run for vice president. That would tank him immediately. People do not like Tucker Carlson like that, dude. Taylor Swift is still whining about what Kanye did to her 7 years ago. A lot of people said she's still playing the scared white woman card. She said when Kanye did what Kanye do, she felt so alone and sad. Whatever that mean. But yeah. All right. A woman is arrested after attempting to burn down Dr. Martin Luther King's childhood home in Atlanta. What in the what? This lady's literally dousing gasoline on the home. What is wrong with this lady? And I cannot tell if she's... Somebody said, girl, he don't live there no more. I mean, she looks... I couldn't tell if she was of the Caucasian persuasion, but from the comments, I guess she's kind of doing it. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I can't really tell. So... But yeah, y'all. She's literally, there's a video of her dousing the home with gasoline. Needless to say, it was not burned down. Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton says he'll prosecute any doctor who performs an abortion for Kate Cox, a Texas woman with a novel pregnancy who was granted an exception to the abortion ban by a judge. She better go to another state. Let's see what else we got. Russell Simmons breaks his silence on sexual allegations brought against him. He's had so many brought against him. He said he took a lie detector test and he passed it. So that's that. Rapper Kodak Black arrested in Florida on cocaine possession and tampering charges. This boy just going and either put him in rehab or lock him up, because he can't stay out of jail. He really can't. The ex-NFL player Sergio Brown enters a not guilty plea in his mother's case. Yeah. There's this viral lady that sings this song, Surprise, Surprise. And it's a viral lady, but somebody said, I just found out the Surprise, Surprise lady, Celia Black, stole a bunch of songs from Dionne Warwick back in the day, including Anyone Who Had a Heart. And Dionne Warwick retweeted that. I wonder if the Surprise Surprise lady is still around, because Dion might be suing. A South Carolina man celebrating his 103rd birthday shares his secret to long life. He says, eat and mind your business. I know that's right. Those are two of my favorite things. I mean, I don't really mind my business. Clearly, I'm on here talking about hot topics all the time, but I'm just saying, I do like eating. Paula Patton's son with Robin Thicke, Julian, he's got some vocals. Let's hear on Julian. Okay, the way these comments was going, I thought this little boy was blowing. I mean, he got, I hear potential in there. He needs a little voice training, but he got some, I can hear something in there. But the way these people was doing, I thought this little boy was just really blowing it up. But yeah, there's that. All right. I think we've covered most news. Let's get over to these crazy Redditors. And disclaimer, these are not my stories. I am reading them from these nut jobs on Reddit. So mother, do not judge me. I love you so much. I do love my mama, y'all. Shout out to my mom. She the bomb. Shout out to my sister who has to Google how long do you boil hot dogs. This is what takes me forever to like sometimes get to. So my sister shares one of my Google accounts, and every time I get ready to open Reddit, she put the most craziest search crap in my phone. How long do you take? What do you mean how long does it take to boil hot dogs? Lady, you about to be 40. I'm hoping one of her kids search for this, because I'm telling you, this stuff is distracting sometimes. I'm like, I'll see some crazy search stuff and I'm like, oh my gosh. All right, let's get into these Reddits, y'all. Straight people, what's your gayest experience? I have none. I think the gayest experience is I dated a dude that I didn't know he had man boobs, and then when he finally took off his shirt, he had man boobs, and I was like, I can't do it, because they feel too much like breasts, and I don't like the way breasts feel. So I guess you can equate that as a gay experience, but yeah. Here is another army. I spent 20 years in the army. I don't know where to start. Somebody said there are straight people in the army. A lot of orange straight or gay army stories. This showed me that I'm as clueless with men as women. I was sitting at a bar at a restaurant waiting for food, sipping bourbon. It's not busy. Some guy sits next to me. He's like 15 years older than me, wearing scrubs. He says he just got off work and needed a drink. There were seats everywhere, but these did have the best view over the TV, so I didn't think none of it. He asked me what I'm drinking. I tell him. He orders two, gives me one. I'm like, sweet. He started talking about his car. I used to sell cars. I tell him he keeps trying to get me to go with him to look at cars for professional advice. I'm like, I'm waiting for my food. He finishes his drink and my food comes. He's like, well, at least you got a free drink. Pays and leaves. And I'm paying for my food. Then it dawns on me. I think he was into me. Or maybe he did just want you to come look at his car. Went to a gay club with my gay roommate. I was dancing and this bear started grinding on my butt and I didn't immediately pull away. Somebody says, sorry, you're gay now. Kissed a girl and her boyfriend once. I was super drunk but only remember kissing her in front of him and had a panic attack the next day. Texted her about it and she said, it's all good. You kissed him too. Beating out two flamboyantly gay men for the role of a flamboyantly gay man in a play. Apparently, I play gay better than them. This is really disgusting. Just disclaimer. One time I was jerking off, it shot way up in the air and some got in my mouth. So, I guess he feels gay. That's crazy, man. Order pink lemonade when regular lemonade was available. I used to like the Backstreet Boys. Some of these are just too... I mean, that one was disgusting, but... Sorry, Mom. I once described food as to die for. I went to a Cher concert. I can read these all day. These people are crazy. But let's move on. Let's move on. Let me pull myself out of that rabbit hole. What's a poor man's meal recipe you're willing to share? I think one that's a staple that most people do is like just taking some white rice and making it sweet and salty at the same time. I used to love eating that when I was not doing well financially. And I mean, it was like a staple. I can't tell you the last time I've had white rice. I haven't ate it in so long. I mean, I've had shrimp fried rice and stuff like that, but no, just white rice for a meal when you didn't have no money. Rice was hitting. Season that stuff up, you got you a whole meal. I learned this when I was studying in Asia. Just add soy sauce to everything. Rice and soy sauce, great. Old shoe soy sauce, great too. Yeah, you can make a gourmet meal out of some rice. When I was in college, I had a lot of broccoli and top ramen. That seemed like a minimally healthy option. Rice and beans, they go far. Cheese cheese quesadillas. Yeah, you can make some cheap cheese quesadillas. A lot of these are including rice. Omelets. Cream corn on toast, gross. Yeah, a lot of people are saying rice and butter, tomatoes with some salt on it or something like that. Good, you can season up a tomato and you'll feel like you're rich eating something, you know, cut it up all fancy, sprinkle some seasoning on it. Some of these are so weird, I just can't, y'all. Some of y'all are just so weird. Yeah, let's go see. Let's see if the women have some sense tonight. Have you been on a date with someone you didn't want to date because you were afraid of what would happen if you said no? I've had some dates and got some free meals out of it, and I knew that that was all it was going to be. I may have said yes to a date but not actually go out with them. If I already felt unsafe while on a date, I might fawn enough to get through it, but I would never follow through with going on a date with someone I was afraid of. Yes, and then I proceeded to act like the most obnoxious person in the world and threw in so many red flags when he wanted to run away from me. Somebody said no. That sounds like a good way to get sexually assaulted. Yeah, you don't want to go on a date with someone you're afraid of. What are some manipulation tactics in interpersonal relationships said or done to you that you now recognize? If you came to them with a problem, they would turn it around to make you feel as the bad guy. They want straightforward communication, but if you do so, they can't handle it. They will not change for you or anybody. You have to accept and respect their personality, but you have to change in order to get along. Double standard. All of this is my boss. Yep. Some of y'all write books about this. This girl says, let me preface this by saying, I love my sister. She's one of my best friends, and while we may not always see eye to eye and have known some very rough patches, I adore her. I also need to say that she's younger than me and that she struggles with a mental disorder, which does not define her. So my sister's a very intelligent person, especially emotionally. She can sense how you feel and react to that. Sadly, she doesn't always use that in a positive way. Ever since we were little, she knew exactly how to get me angry beyond myself. She prized and prized and prized until she snapped. Till you snap. As we got older, her manipulation tactics got more and more subtle, but I also learned to recognize them, and I learned how to control myself and how to react so that she doesn't get what she wants. When she raises her voice or starts cursing, I reply with a matter-of-fact tone. It irks her because she's not getting the response she needs. Oftentimes, she doesn't realize how far she's going. If I keep talking at a normal level, she starts to realize she's shouting. If she curses at me, I ask her to stop. Usually, she'll respond with, I wasn't cursing at you. No? Then how would you label words like the profanities? She usually calms down at that point because she realizes she's going too far. It works wonders ever since I've been using it with people when they get agitated or whatever extent it may be. It makes you come across as controlled and controlled. Yeah, I mean, one thing you gotta remember is to not let your environment control you. You control the environment. And believe me, some people can take you there, but you cannot give people your energy, man. Just let it go. All right, let's get into these story times, y'all.
I think it should be a bigger story, and I don't think it's going to get covered.
Okay.
All right, so can I explain it to you?
Yeah.
And then you can make me, just tell me if I sound crazy.
Okay.
Because I'm going to sound crazy.
Yeah.
Okay. 99% of the phones in the world are being tracked by every single government through push notifications, and the United States government actually has a gag order on the two largest phone companies through their operating systems to make sure that no one knows about it, and it was just confirmed by a letter via the chairman of the Committee on Finance in the Senate.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
So you're saying that all the governments?
So this is how he words it. All right, okay. Senator Ron Wyden, in a letter to the Attorney General, he states that last year he got a tip, his office got a tip, that foreign governments were reaching out to Google and Apple. Now, that's important because Android phones make up 70% of every operating system in the world.
All right.
On every phone.
Okay.
The other 29% is Apple.
Yeah.
Both of those companies were being reached out to by foreign governments who were requesting push notification data.
Push notification data?
So you know when somebody sends you a text?
Yeah.
Okay, and you get that little thing that pops up at the top of the screen?
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, you're like this thing. We're like, Amazon sends you a little bing. It's like, oh, just so you know, Magneto helmets are 30% off. And then you click the button and buy.
I cannot believe you bought that Magneto helmet.
Okay, ignore this. The governments are tracking us, okay?
All right.
I will put it on so they don't hear my thoughts.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay. So when you get that, that's a push notification.
Yeah.
Okay? But that doesn't come directly from your app. That, through these services, goes from the app to a cloud server.
Okay.
And then it goes to your phone.
All right.
So these governments are subpoena and requesting the information from the cloud server. Not from your phone, not from the app, but from Google and from Apple.
Uh-huh.
And so these governments, we don't know what governments, it just says in the letter, foreign countries are reaching out and collecting this data. Now, the assumption being ones that the United States has security partnerships with throughout the world.
Maybe.
But also, maybe the United States government as well. Because when his office reached out and were like, we want more information about this, both Google and Apple stated to the senator, who is the chairman of the Committee on Finance, he has the clearance.
Mm-hmm.
We can't tell you because we're under a gag order by the United States government. So this senator is asking the Attorney General, hey, lift the gag order and let people know if they're being surveilled through the push notifications. Because those push notifications could have things like in a text, who the text came from, maybe like a little bit of the preview of the body of the text, maybe other metadata in there, like where the text was being sent from or other things. Like when you drop a pin to tell someone your location, and it tells you in the push notification, tons of information could be up there.
Yeah.
And like, this just came out, but I'm already seeing it like not getting any traction anywhere.
Why not?
Well, because Apple and Google pay a lot in advertising, and they also run the algorithms that track of how people find out information.
Okay, yeah, so they're not going to want this to get out.
Yeah, and so they're just going to be like, maybe it'll just go away.
So should we get tinfoil and make tinfoil hats?
No, I bought a Magneto helmet.
I know you bought a Magneto
helmet. That way they can't read my push notifications.
I don't think it's going to work.
I think I couldn't hurt.
That dialogue was interesting. But yeah, we know we've been spied on. If you don't think your phone's been spied on, I don't really know what to tell you. We kind of know that.
Hey, where you calling from?
Tampa, Florida.
Okay, go ahead, baby. Hit me with your question. Let's go.
I'm 32. Okay. I don't have four kids. I was young, you know.
You're always lying, talking about I was young. You was fast as fuck.
Yeah, you ain't let me get it out. You ain't let me get it out. 18, 19 years old, I was hunching. I was throwing it. I was hunching.
Okay.
I got four, in the midst of me doing all that, I got four kids. I got a set of twins, and I got a little girl and a little boy. My youngest two kids, their fathers are full-time. They take them, they get them, everything.
Okay.
The issue is my older two kids. I texted two niggas first that I thought was my baby daddy. They wasn't it. I got another dude, but I haven't texted him. I haven't talked to him, nothing, none of that. Mm-hmm. But the question is, what should I do? Because I reached out to him. He won't, you know, respond. I reached out to the mother. The mother just basically, like, disregarded everything that I said because my kid, my oldest, the twins, are 13 now. I understand that the person that I want to test, he has a family, he has a wife, he has all of that stuff going on. At the time, it wasn't like that. It was a one-time thing, and I just happened to get pregnant. I don't want to mess up no homes or cause any problems, any friction, none of that. So I'm just stuck on what I should do. I wrote the mom, I wrote the father. Nobody has hit me back. I take.
Well, listen, you didn't pop up with a baby. You popped up with a couple.
Yeah, that was me. It was me. Like, I was, you know, being reckless with my body and stuff. So, and the result of that, I, you know, got kids and stuff. I take full accountability for my part and what I did.
But how sure are you that he's a father?
It was three different dudes that I was messing with at the same time. Wow. The first two dudes I tested, and this last dude, I'm not 100% sure. I'm not even gonna say I'm 100% sure. I just want him to take the test.
You could do a court order test. You know how Florida do. You go down there, ask for some child support, and they'll make him show up to take the test.
And see, this is the thing. The second dude that I tried to, he ran from the test, everything. Ran completely, said F all of that. And it took literally up until my children were about 11 years old for him to finally go take the test. And it came back that he wasn't the father. So a lot of the court defaulted him the father of my kids because they tried three times to get him to do a DNA test. And he didn't do it. So they defaulted him.
Yeah.
So now we in the process. I'm trying to get him, like, situated. I'm trying to help him get off of child support and all of that stuff. Because I'm a woman. I'm not going to keep taking money from this man knowing that he's not the father of my kid.
You know you got to get it back, right?
Huh?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But the reason he's paying child support is because he didn't take the test.
You got to get it back.
Oh.
If you undo him as a father, you got to refund that.
So what do you think I should do? Keep it like that and let that man keep paying it?
I'm not a lawyer. However, this is what I would do. And you do need to seek a lawyer for this. But this is what I would do. I would make a deal with him. I would say I will take you off child support and undefault you as the father and basically clear the back pay if you do not require me to pay it back.
Okay, cool.
So that's how you're going to do that, but you got to get it in writing. So if he does try to say, or the court tries to enforce something, him saying he doesn't want it, you got that in writing. So make sure you get that notarized.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah. But the thing I'm confused about is the last dude. Like, I'm just like, what should I do?
Now you just gonna have to do the same process that you did with the second dude.
Yeah.
You just better hope you're right this time.
Yeah, I hope I'm right too, shit. Listen. We all have our moments where we just be like, you know, I was all over the place.
Go ahead and get a written contract from him. Then go get the lawyer and go get everything undone.
Yeah, I'm going to give y'all an update, you know.
And don't be no mean baby mama to that wife now.
Oh, no. I'm not even that type. I'm not even like that. I have no issues with
you go through her. You go through her when you want to deal with him. So she feels empowered about the situation.
Right. You're absolutely right. All right. Thank you, Tasha. I appreciate it.
Love you.
Love you, too.
All right. Bye-bye.
That is a crazy story, but I know that, like, child support, after hearing her story, I see why the child support be wore out, because some of y'all don't know who y'all child's father is, and y'all every day run into this office and they just like, look, they tired of the mama and they tired of the daddy. They like, we didn't try three times, you the daddy. And now she like, no, it ain't him. I'm gonna try. And it's like, how many men is... That was a crazy story. But if I was a dude that is potentially the father, if I was her, I just let her kids wait till they 18. I mean, they 13 at this point, lady. I mean, he seems not interested. I mean, that's the problem with being a loose woman. Like, dudes are not going to take you serious when you try to put the baby on them. And not to say he's not guilty, because he's just as guilty of sleeping with somebody that was out in these streets. And you, when you're out in these streets, there's consequences to that.
Hi, y'all. If you're here for my divorce drama, pull up a chair. It's getting real good for you and real bad for me. So, the climax of this story is, I'm just going to go ahead and give you that. Who wants to wait on it? I'm going to be homeless in 2 days. Homeless, completely homeless. And no resources to live. I've been completely cut off. Bank accounts, credit cards, nothing. I have nothing. I have no way to buy food. No way to put gas in my car. My husband filed for divorce. He's a divorce attorney, if you missed that part. Oh, but he hired a divorce attorney. And that divorce attorney, his last name is my maiden name. I can't find an attorney willing to help me. I found one attorney after I called, no exaggeration, 100 of them from East Tennessee to West Tennessee and all in the middle. No one wants to go against another attorney personally, especially when they're doing stuff like this, because they know it's wrong. People don't want to mess up their work relationships when their job is already going against one another. They don't want to make it personal because they might need each other once in a while. And I get it. I get it. But I also get that this is a job and I'm a real person with a real life and I need help. I can't pay the giant retainer fee to the attorney who is actually willing to help me, who looks at this as he should, a job. But to do a job, you need to get paid, and I get it. But what I don't get is how everyone is allowing this to happen to me. I don't understand how his mama is letting him get away with it. I don't understand how his friends are letting him get away with it. I'm telling you, I'm going to be homeless in 2 days. And yes, I can sleep on my sister's couch for a couple nights, but she has a family and a little boy. And nobody wants another person's life being dumped into their life when it's not necessary. It's not necessary. I just need access to my own resources to live. He's living just fine. I don't understand. How is he able to go out to eat with his coworkers and stop at fast food and cut me off from buying food?
So anyway, people in the comments were telling her, don't move, don't leave the house. You know, hopefully she gets viral on TikTok and somebody will pay a retainer fee. But normally in divorces, I know she's married to a divorce attorney, but normally they let you, like, they can make your spouse pay somehow. They can collect it one way or the other.
Bishop Boy Gerald Jackson from the North Carolina Beat. A North Carolina man who had been missing for nearly 2 months before his body was discovered in Harnett County on November 20th was killed by his sister's boyfriend, according to police in Dunn, North Carolina. But sources tell the North Carolina Beat that the victim and the alleged killer once had a secret dating relationship back in 2016, way before the alleged killer met the victim's sister. A source close to the victim, who you see right here, 23-year-old Tyrone Taylor, told the North Carolina Beat that the story circulating around that Tyrone slept with his sister's boyfriend, 26-year-old Daquan Thomas, behind her back is false. Now, according to the source, they tell us that Daquan and Tyrone first started talking back in 2016 after they met on social media. Now, according to our source, they tell us that during the time that these two were talking, they would occasionally meet up, you know, do what they do. And Daquan was down low, but he didn't want anyone to know that he was attracted to Tyrone and was talking to Tyrone. Now, according to our source, they tell us that Tyrone confided into a lot of people about this fling that he had for Daquan and the fling that Daquan had for him. And our source was one of those people that Tyrone confided in. Now, during that time that Daquan and Tyrone was messing around, that following year in 2017, the source tell us that Daquan had got into some trouble with a girl he was messing with in Spring Lake. Now, according to sources, Daquan and the girl had got into a real bad argument and something went down. According to news reports and sources, Daquan kidnapped the woman's daughter and took his son home and then left the woman's daughter in an abandoned mobile home in Spring Lake. Now, according to our source, Daquan had to go do some prison time for those kidnapping charges. But when he got out in 2021, he started messing around with Tyrone's sister, Tanisha Taylor, who you see right here. While Tanisha and Daquan was in a relationship, she told the courts in a September 14 domestic violence restraining order that he bound her to a chair and burned her. She also told the court that he told her that he was going to blow her up. She stated that this incident happened in August on the 30th. On October 10th, police arrested Daquan in connection with the incident with Tanisha. Police charged him with second-degree kidnapping as well as misdemeanor counts of assault on a female and communicating threat. According to our source, they tell us that they are so out of the blue or unaware of what could have happened to make Daquan kill Tyrone, allegedly kill Tyrone. According to Dunn Police, Tyrone Taylor was last seen on Tuesday, September the 5th. That same day, his mom, Amy Ross, had told police that he went down to Sampson County to see his father. She said that he returned back to Dunn, came by her house before he went to his home on Susan Tart Road. The next day, Ms. Ross said that she received a phone call from Tyrone's father saying that he could not get in contact with Tyrone. She told local reporters that it was unusual for Tyrone not to pick up his phone. Family went by Tyrone's apartment and him nor his car was there. On September 8th, Dunn police told Tyrone's family that his car had been found burned in Cumberland County, North Carolina, which is just 31 miles away from Dunn. Sources tell the North Carolina Beat that while Daquan was messing around with Tyrone's sister Tanisha, Daquan still was messing around with Tyrone. Sources say eventually Tanisha got comfortable with Daquan messing with her and her brother. On November 20th, approximately 2:35 p.m., some workers was clearing out a lot on Shady Grove Road when they found a body. Police said that they could not identify the race or the sex of the human remains due to the advanced state of decomposition. On this past Thursday, authorities identified those remains as 23-year-old Tyrone Taylor. And as for Daquan Thomas, he is in jail without the bail.
Daquan looked like he looked mental.
I told you Hollywood is coming to collect on that karma, goddammit. Yes. No, they're pulling up all interviews of Usher talking about molestation, but he didn't know that it was molestation. He didn't know that he was being groomed. You know, L.A. Reid just got hit with a lawsuit, a sexual assault lawsuit, too, under the New York Survivors Act. It's just too much. And Diddy got hit as well. Now, Usher, he's trying to really choose his words carefully with this, but go ahead. We can read it between the lines. I hope so. Let's go.
And I lived with Sean Puffy Combs for a year.
That's the crazy thing. Now, that was L.A. Reid's idea, right? We're sending you over to something called Puffy Flavor Camp.
There you go.
To learn Flavor some... Camp.
Yeah, that's what it was called. And you're going to go to Puff Daddy's.
He's in the 90s. Do you understand what that's like?
Puffy's place was like just filled with chicks and orgy going nonstop, right?
No, not really. Hey, it was curious. I got a chance to see some things.
Yeah, but you were 13. What were you saying?
I went there to see the lifestyle. Right. And I saw it. But I don't know if I could indulge and understand what I was even looking at. It was pretty wild.
So nobody tried to, you know, some woman didn't.
I didn't say that.
Okay.
What I did say is that there were very curious things taking place.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't necessarily understand.
I was so mesmerized. I don't even know what you're talking about. I was just so blown away by the stamina, the connection, being able to connect with that old source. Now, I saw some fucking shit out there. Don't look all those dancing and all that. To be kind of bring it in. Yeah, we all do this shit for you. We take nobody else with you. We take that time, boy.
So L.A. Reid sent him down to the take that mansion. There was a lot of shit going on that Usher saw at 13 years old. He ain't gonna talk about the things he participated in, because I'm sure deep down inside, he's like, well, I wanted it. But when you're that young, you don't know what you want because your brain hasn't developed yet. So what they were trying to give Usher was sex appeal to sell. That's why when he came out at such a young age, we all thought he was older because he had been trained. This is what you call grooming. And that's why Usher only dates older women. We ain't gonna talk about that, because Usher's doing great right now in his career. And honestly, he can't really help, you know, what went on. He was a child. But one day, I'm sure he'll eventually see that I was groomed into what I am.
I do wonder about that. That is interesting. Because Usher does like him an older woman. And I mean, some men just like older women. But I mean, you know, back in the 90s was a wild time with these kids and these artists and these parents sending their kids to places. Yeah.
My ex-husband pays me $1,700 a month in child support and pays my car insurance and my phone bill. And that makes a lot of people mad. So let's talk about it while I give you an apartment tour. I hear a lot of men on this app say that if their baby mother put them on child support, then that's all they're going to do. That as long as the kid is taken care of, they don't really care how their baby mama lives. But here's the thing. Kids cost money, and not just monetarily. My daughter's father wants my daughter in a great neighborhood and in a good school. So rent in those places are obviously going to be more expensive. My daughter's father will always help me with rent if I need it. A car is a necessity where I live as well. I have to take my daughter back and forth to school, so my ex has no problem paying my car insurance. My daughter likes to call her dad whenever she wants, so he has no problem paying my phone bill. And if my daughter asks me for something and I can't get it for her, my ex sends me the money for it. He never says, ain't that what child support is for? Y'all want y'all baby mothers to struggle so bad, and it's kind of weird. But what do y'all think? What are your views on child support?
I hope he keeps that up, because it sounds like he don't have a wife right now, because men will take care of you, like, when y'all first fresh off breakup, child support, whatever you need, but when they get a new wife and they get some new kids, sometimes things change. But you know what's not changing? Me. I'll be back next week. Y'all have an amazing weekend, y'all. Like, whatever y'all went through this week, shake it off. You will win. You will win. You will win. You will win. Have an amazing, blessed weekend, y'all.